Okay, I just wanted to talk a few minutes about what I think about the EA / Maxis fiasco that's been going on lately, and that's about all. First, a little background real quick on me, even though many of you have been watching me for a while already know this, just to get this out of the way so you understand why I say the things I'm about to say. For the longest time, majority of my life, you might as well say, I have been primarily, I guess you would call it a PC gamer. I don't like using that term, computer gamer. And even though I had consoles at the same time, for outdoing that, primarily I've played the most things on the computer. I have used the computer the most for playing games and so on and so forth. I still do to an extent, but not really much anymore. But what I'm saying is, you know, I've been playing SimCity games for a very long time. In fact, I still own the very first SimCity. It doesn't work anymore because it won't work on modern operating systems, but I do have it. I basically played SimCity games up to Societies. In fact, I didn't like the one before Societies, but Societies is really awful, and I just called it quits then. I mean, I wanted to call it quits with The Sims, but that has mostly maintained its somewhat quality, even after Maxis stopped making it and Will Wright left the series. But anyway, what's going on with this? They should have realized this was going to backlash at them. First of all, it's an absolute lie. They did not have to make it online. Always connected. There's no reason for it. None of the other SimCities were. There is no reason to do it with this one. None of the reasons they gave are legitimate or even factual reasons why they need to do that, especially on the computer. Now, if they're talking about consoles because they can't handle as much going on, maybe you might be able to push that idea like they were trying to, but no, it doesn't work on the computer. A computer can handle what that game is going to crank out. And that's why you have settings so you can lower it so it can run on lower spec hardware. That's why you have that kind of stuff in a computer game. There is no reason they had to make it online always, unless, which is this is the real reason, because they were paranoid and they just wanted to have control, and that's what it always is about with this kind of DRM. It's all about control. They want to fully control everything. They don't want you doing anything with it. So their only way, they think, to do this, which is anti-consumer and anti-gamer and unfriendly practice, is to make you always have to be connected to the internet so you cannot play a single player. Which, SimCity, the series, ever since it was first created, the first one came out, has always been primarily a single player game. That's what most people, and pretty much the majority, play it for. They don't play it to play with other people, they play it single player. They play it by themselves, they play it on the laptop when they're on the train, playing whatever the hell else it is, and they play it offline single player. That's the way the series has always been, and will continue to be played for the most majority out there. That's the way it is. The Sims works the same way. Most people play that by themselves. They don't want to play it with other people. And again, this is another case of you cannot and should not shoehorn multiplayer in a game that does not make sense or does not belong there or is a half-baked idea. Not a good thing to do. They should have also known, because of all this backlash, that it's not going to hurt. It's going to hurt their reputation even more than some of the other stuff they've been doing lately. And you have to think of it this way too. Before this happened, they already had a lot of people pissed off at them. EA already has a bad reputation for all the other things they've been doing with other series and other things they say and do, which makes no sense. In fact, as the day I'm making this, I think it was the day before or the day before that, the EA CEO, he actually resigned. So, you could say the writing's on the wall, he sees that as a sinking ship, it's kind of like Titanic. And I actually couldn't blame him, and I was actually going to make a thing talking about that, but I might as well say it right here now. Could he be the first of many? I think he will be. There's a lot of people, and I mean a lot of people, that absolutely hate EA's guts right now, just like Activision. Although, the argument has always been, which is worse, Activision or EA? I think even now, I could say that EA is the worst. I hate Activision, always have, but EA is even worse. And again, I have to bring up EA and Electronic Arts are two different companies, whether you realize what that means or not. They are not the same two companies. Electronic Arts is dead. They don't exist anymore. All that's left is EA. And in its place was a very evil company that just does all this ridiculous shit. They run many series and franchises that a lot of people love, me included, into the ground. I bought a lot of Electronic Arts games. One in particular, many of you that watch me, I'm pretty sure you know which one I'm talking about because of how much I love cars and automobiles. In fact, I cannot talk about that because it will just piss me off so much, which is why I haven't made anything talking about Need for Speed, and I will not do it. So, but then we come back to SimCity, which is what this is about. I played SimCity a lot. I love that series. In fact, my favorite one is still on the Super Nintendo, which is the first one. And by the way, the one that just came out, the one this is all about, is really should be called SimCity 5, but because of some stupid bullshit fad that companies are doing anymore when they remake a game, kind of like Tomb Raider. Oh no, we're not going to give it an actual name. We're just going to name it the same thing as the first one. It's just, they're not doing anything right. And this is just very vindictive of all the things that are going on right now in the current industry. It's not just this. There's a lot of bad things going on. THQ is going out of business. EA keeps doing all this bad stuff. They come out with this new game and it's absolutely abysmal. You can't even play it when the thing first came out on the first day. The servers weren't even working because it's online always thing. And then they come out a few days after and they say, we could have done offline, but we just didn't feel like it. That's basically what it came down to. So it's all their fault. This is all their fault. They're the only ones you can blame for it. But then you also have to blame people who buy this type of game and support this kind of idea. I've said it before and I'll say it again. So many of other people, and I'm not going to cite TB here, although I could, because he's not the only one. I've been saying this for many years because I've realized this on my own, because I'm smart enough and I have common sense to realize this. If you do not like something, or if you don't like it, and it's just anti-consumer and anti-unfriendly practices, whatever you want to call that, you should not support it. Do not support this kind of stuff, because that's the only way you can send a message. If you do support it, that just tells them to keep doing this kind of stuff, and then they just, one by one, slowly but surely, will keep doing invasive things, invading your privacy, or just, you know, destroying things as they are. They ruin this. This could have been a good game. A lot of people have said it. If you look at comments, anything on all these articles, they say this could have been a good game, but they screwed it up. Maxis and EA got greedy. EA's always been greedy, but Maxis, they've changed. They went to the dark side, basically. That's what this whole comes down to. Those two got greedy. One got more greedy than it already was, but Maxis is the one that just became greedy. It's a shame, really. This didn't have to turn out this way. But, you know, what can you say? That's the way things are going in the current industry, and that's why I really don't want to be a part of it and don't want to support it. This is just another reason on top of many. I was actually contemplating getting SimCity 5, this one that just came out, yes, until I heard about all this kind of stuff. It wasn't even that long after they announced that they said about this online always thing and the smaller cities and all that kind of crap. And that was when I decided, and I knew, no, this is bad. I cannot do this. I will not support this. And I knew it was going to be an absolute disaster. And that's what happened. And that's all there is to it. So thanks for listening. Feel free to say what you think about this whole thing. If you have any opinion on it, you don't have to. And I will see you next time.